حي على الفلاح.
إن الحمد لله نحمده تعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده ربي لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Amma ba'du, ibadullah. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his countless favors and ni'mas that he has bestowed upon us. He who Allah guides, none can lead him astray. And he who is led astray, none can guide them. O you who believe, fear Allah as he ought to be feared. Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, kama akhbarat Aisha radiyallahu anha, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yastahibbu al-jawami' min al-du'a. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to like the supplications and the du'a are all comprehensive and general for the fa'idah and for the benefit that was in it. Wa ja'a fi sahihi Muslim min hadithi ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu anna nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kana yaqul Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa والعفاف والغنى. In Sahih Muslim, from the hadith of Ibn Mas'ud, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make supplication and call to Allah with this dua: O Allah, I ask you for guidance and piety and abstinence and contentment. Knowing the ad'iyah and the supplication of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is very important. Because when you study and when you memorize and you look at the different supplications that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make, you are aware of the good of the life this world and the hereafter, and that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was anxious to acquire. And you also become aware of that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek refuge in Allah from, and what he was afraid of, and what he would flee to and try to avoid. Brothers in Islam, in this dua is all comprehensive, and you are in need of the likes of this dua in order to be successful in your religion, in order to be successful in your steadfastness, in order to be successful in your obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just based upon the masjid that you go to. It's not just based upon the people you know them and the people who know you. Na'am. Walakin obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is based on guidance and taqwa. And these are the first two things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam put together in this dua. Allahumma inni as'aluka al-huda wa-tuqa wal-afaf wal-ghina. Guidance is knowledge, is beneficial knowledge. Knowledge of the Islam, knowledge of the halal and the haram. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you this. Oh, you Muslim, you know the halal and you know haram. You know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded and made wajib and obligatory. And you know what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made prohibited, and what he has made haram, and what he has prevented you from. So it's upon you to have taqwa concerning this matter. Meaning you have to implement this thing. You cannot have knowledge without implementation. You cannot have taqwa, you cannot have guidance, then you don't have the taqwa. Taqwa means that you fulfill your responsibilities and that you avoid your prohibitions. Na'am ya ibadullah. And this is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to come with. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam with these two things. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ. Al-huda is al-ilm al-nafi', is beneficial knowledge. وَدِينُ الْحَقِّ is good deeds. Na'am ya ibadullah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent with beneficial knowledge, with guidance in the time of ignorance. You have knowledge. You have been given knowledge from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How many ignorant disbelievers walk upon you every day? They don't know how to dress. They don't know how to speak. They don't know halal or haram when it comes to their women, when it comes to their children, when it comes to their parents, when it comes to their food, when it comes to their money. You have been given this knowledge. You have been given guidance. It's not enough for you to suffice with guidance, but you have to have along with it taqwa. And taqwa means to fulfill what you are commanded and to avoid that which you have been prohibited. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about His Prophet Ibrahim, ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا. Ibrahim, he wasn't Jewish, nor was he Christian. Jewish are people who are known to have knowledge, but their actions contradict it. Christians are people to be ignorant, but they have a lot of ibadat, and they have a lot of acts of worship. You cannot be like this or like that. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala negated from Ibrahim these two descriptions, He affirmed for him two other descriptions. ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما. نعم نعم يا عبد الله. Ibrahim, he was not Jewish, nor was he Christian. ولكن كان حنيفا. He was worshipping Allah one alone. Musliman, in submission to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that which you know from the halal, and that which you know from the haram, you have to be in compliance with it. It is not sufficient that you have knowledge and you don't have the necessary actions to go along with it. Na'am Abdullah. But when you have knowledge and you have guidance and you don't act according to it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may snatch it from you. Na'am Ya Ibadullah. There is no guidance and there's no knowledge when there's no actions according to it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ آمَنَ إِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا ثُمَّ اهْتَدَى. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. Really, I'm all forgiven to the one who repents and he believes and he has good deeds. Then he's guided. Then he's guided. There is any guide. There is no guidance if you don't have good deeds. نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by his ni'mah, he has made this deen clear. Everything is clear to you. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ الْحَلَالَ بَيِّنْ وَإِنَّ الْحَرَامَ بَيِّنْ. It's clear to you. You have been guided. How many people affront you every day? They don't know the halal. They don't know haram. So they fall into this and they fall into that out of ignorance. But you, my dear brother, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has favored you over others. You have to work according to it. You have to have actions along with your what? Along with knowledge. I mean, you have to have taqwa along with your guidance. You have been guided. Na'am. Inna al-halal bayyin wa inna al-haram bayyin. Verily the halal is clear and the haram is clear. Wa baynahuma umurun mushtabihatun la ya'lamuhunna kathirun minan nas. And there are affairs that are not clear. Many of the people don't know of these affairs. فَمَنِ اتَّقَى الشُّبَهَاتِ قُلِ اسْتَبْرَعَ لِدِينِهِ وَعِرْضِهِ. Those who are cautious and stay away from matters that you're not clear about, he has protected his religion, meaning that which is between him and Allah. وَعِرْضِهِ, that which is between him and the people, he has protected these things. وَمَنْ وَقَعَ فِي الشُّبَهَاتِ وَقَعَ فِي الْحَرَامِ. Those who fall into the matters that are great, and he's not sure about it, it's not for him just to indulge in it and act in it because he doesn't know what it is, but he should stay away from it. Na'am ya ibadullah. Wa nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul da' ma yaribuk ila ma la yaribuk. Leave off for what you don't know. If you don't know it and you're doubt about it, leave it on. Leave it off for that which you know, and that which you know, act according to it. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا لما تقولون ما لا تفعلون. Why do you do لما تقولون? Why do you say that which you don't do? You say with your heart that this is halal and this is haram and that this is wajib and when this is manhi and anhu and this is not permissible. Then why do your actions go against that? كبر مقتا عند الله أن تقولوا ما لا تفعلون. This is something that's greatly hated by Allah, that you say what you don't do. نعم يا عباد الله. ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لعلي بن أبي طالب قل اللهم اهدني وسددني. Oh Allah, guide me and سددني, meaning give me tawfiq. And another narration قال اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والسداد. These two things must be together. If you want obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you want obedience, if you want to be steadfast, if you want to be on the Surat al-Mustaqim, it is not sufficient that you just have guidance to Islam, but you have to act according to it. As-sadad is tawfiq. It means that you reach the goal. Guidance, that you're aware of what is halal, what is haram, what's wajib on you, and what's not permissible for you. But sadad is that you reach the goal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you goals and objectives to acquire. And abstaining from that which is haram, and abstaining from that which is not suitable, abstaining from that which is shameful, then you have to do the work and obtain these things. Na'am ya Abdullah. Ma atakum ar-rasulu fakhudhuhu wa ma nahakum anhu fantahu wattaqullah. This is taqwa. This is what you have to be upon Islam. Islam has to have with guidance good deeds. Ma atakum ar-rasulu fakhudhuhu. That which the Prophet has given you, take it. Everything. Don't make something small. Don't say this is just mustahab. This is just recommended. Allah shara'ahu li nafsik wa huwa laghaniyun anhu. Allah established it and stipulated for your benefit. Allah is not in need of it. Wa anta fi amassil haja ilayk. And you are in dire need of everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has stipulated. Whether you deem it kabir or whether you deem it saghir. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُصْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. You have in the Messenger of Allah the most perfect example. كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول اللهم إني أعوذ بك من أربع. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to say, Allah, I seek refuge in you from four things. أعوذ بك من علم لا ينفع. I seek refuge in you from knowledge that doesn't benefit. Your knowledge of the halal, your knowledge of the haram, it has to benefit you in your religion. The benefit, the knowledge of that which is wajib, the knowledge of that which is manhiyan an you, it has to benefit you in your religion. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min ilmin la yanfa. Seek refuge in you that I have knowledge, it doesn't benefit me. Wa qalbin la yakhsha. And a heart, it doesn't fear Allah. Wa nafsin la tashba. And a soul is never satisfied. Wa du'a in la yusma. And from a du'a that's not answered because of your disobedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am ya ibadullah. Verily, if you do not attach taqwa to your guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may snatch it away from you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Inna alladhina irtaddu ala adbarihim min ba'di ma tabayyana lahumul huda ash-shaytanu sawwala lahum wa amla lahum. Really, those who reverted back to disbelief after guidance was clear to them, what happened to them? Shaytan beautified for them the haram and let them think that they have time. Na'am ya ibadallah, hold fast to your religion. Nabiyyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam kathirun kana yaqul ya muqallib al-qulub thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, oh, the changer of the heart, keep my heart firm on this deen. How is your heart going to be firm on this deen? Is it sufficient that you know the halal? Is it sufficient that you know this and you know that? You have to act according to it. Na'am ya ibadullah. When the Prophet sallallahu Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ وَاللَّهُ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمِ الْفَاسِقِينَ. When they went astray, Allah turned their hearts astray. When they turned astray, Allah turned their hearts astray. And Allah does not guide the sinning people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, رَبَّنَا لَا تُزِغْ قُلُوبَنَا بَعْدَ إِذْ هَدَيْتَنَا. نَعَمْ نَعَمْ يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ. Oh, our Lord, don't lead us astray after you have guided us. You have to have with your guidance taqwa. اللهم إني أسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى والحمد لله. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه كما يحب ربنا ويرضى. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. In the second half, in the second part of this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam combined two important things. Al-afaf wal-ghina. Al-afaf huwa al-kaf anil haram wa ma la yubah wal-aib. Na'am ya Abdullah, afaf is abstinence. that you stay away from the haram, and that which is not permissible, and that which is shameful, and that which is low. Anta asif, ya Abdullah. You are asif. You abstain from the things that are shameful, the things that are low, the things haram. You don't do that. Anta asif. Na'am. Taqwa is general. Asif is specific. Taqwa, iffa, is specific. Taqwa means you do what you're commanded and you abstain from that which is haram. But iffa is specifically with abstinence and staying away from that which is haram. It comes from the hadith of Abi Sufyan that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in awal Islam, at the beginning of Islam, he says, كان يأمرنا بالصلاه والصدق والعفاف والصله. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he's still in Mecca, he used to command them with the salah and with being truthful and with afaf, that they abstain from that which is low, they abstain from that which is shameful, and that they have family ties. Na'am ya Abdullah, this quality of a Muslim, that he abstains from that which is haram, it must be accompanied with ghina, wal qana'ah, satisfaction and contentment. You can't abstain from that which is haram and say this haram, what deep down inside you desire. Deep down inside, you want it and you like it. You have to have qana'ah that this is haram and I'm pleased that it's haram. Na'am ya Abdullah. You have to know this haram and you have to hate it and you have to stay away from it. Abdullah, ja'an min hadithi Abdullah bin Amr al-Nas, and the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam qad, qad aflaha man aslam wa ruziqa kafafan wa qanna'ahu Allahu bima ataahu. He is successful. The one who has been guided to Islam and Allah has given him provision that's just sufficient and he's content. He's ghina, he's content with what Allah has given him. Not just from the dunya, even from the deen. Be content with what Allah has given you from the dunya, but also be content with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made haram for you. He wants for you best. He wants for you izzah. He wants for you nabafa. He wants for you nazaha. He wants for you rif'ah. Be pleased with this. Don't desire. Don't be your worst enemy. That you say this is haram and this is not permissible. And deep down inside, you like this. You want this. Don't be of those that say this is wajib. I must do this. But deep down inside, you're lazy about it. You don't want to do it. And then and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, as it comes from the hadith of Fadad ibn Ubaid, طوبى لمن هودي إلى الإسلام وكان عيشه كفافا وقنع. طوبى, Jannah, for the one who has been guided to Islam, his provisions are low and he's satisfied. He's content. He's pleased with it. Be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you from the life of this world and what he has given you from your religion. Na'am Abdullah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, wasbir nafsaka مع الذين يدعون ربهم بالغداة والعشي. Make yourself patient with those who call on Allah by day and night. Make yourself patient being amongst the Muslims. ولا تعد عيناك عنهم. Don't take your eyes off of the believers. تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا. Chasing the life of this world and the wealth of this world. ولا تعد عيناك عنهم تريد زينة الحياة الدنيا ولا تطع من أغفلنا قلبه عن ذكرنا. And don't follow those that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made them unaware and blind of the guidance of Allah. Don't befriend the mushrikeen. Don't look up to them. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال انظروا إلى من أسفل منكم ولا تنظروا إلى ما فوقكم. Look to those who have been given less than you. And don't look to those who have been given more to you. It's better for you not to make small of the ni'mah of Allah upon you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has chosen you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you from the halal and haram. And has given you from the dunya. Iqtani', be content with it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the believers, وَلَا تَمُدَّنَّ عَيْنَيْكَ إِلَى مَا مَتَّعْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّنْهُمْ زَهْرَةَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا لِنَفْتِينَهُمْ فِيهِ وَرِزْقُ رَبِّكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَبَقَى. And don't extend your eyes to that which we have given groups of them from the pleasures of this dunya. Na'am ya Abdullah. Nabiyuna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam atahu fatan شاباً فقال يا رسول الله إذن لي بالزنا. In the hadith of Abi Umama and Abi Dawood, a young man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, "O Messenger of Allah, make permissible for me fornication, azina, this horrible, disgusting act." فَأَصَّحَابَ زَجُدُوهُ قَالُوا مَهْ مَهْ. The Sahaba, they rebuked him and told him, "Be quiet, don't say this." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Udunu, udunu." The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Come close." قَالَ لَهُ أَتُحِبُّهُ لِأُمَّكَ. He said, "Do you like this for your mother?" قَالَ لَا وَاللَّهِ, I don't like it. أَتُحِبُّهُ لِأُخْتِكَ. Do you like this for your sister? أَتُحِبُّهُ لِبِنْتِكَ. Do you like it for your daughter? أَتُحِبُّهُ لِعَمَّتِكَ. Do you like this for your aunt? أَتُحِبُّهُ لِخَالِتِكَ. He made him this action disgusting to him. Every time he said, "No, I don't like it for my mother." قَالَ وَكَذَلِكَ النَّاسِ لَا يُحِبُّونَهُ لِأُمِّهَاتِهِمْ. He said, "Also the people don't like this for their mothers." وَكَذَلِكَ النَّاسِ مَا يُحِبُّونَ هَذَا لِبَنَاتِهِمْ وَلَا يُحِبُّونَ هَذَا لِأَخْوَاتِهِمْ. Also the people don't like this for their daughters and not for their sisters. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قَالَ اللَّهُمَّ اغْفِرْ ذَنْبَهُ طَهِّرْ قَلْبَهُ وَحَسِّنْ فَرْجَهُ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made dua for him. "Oh Allah, forgive his sins and purify his heart and protect his private part." Your heart has to be pure and your heart has to be content with that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed. Na'am ya Abdullah. So that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prohibited, strive to have qana'ah. Strive to have satisfaction and pleasure and contentment with everything from this deen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for his aid and for his success. Subhanaka Allahumma wa bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Walhamdulillah.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
It's though straighten the rows. Close the gaps. Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Malik Yawm Al-Din. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين. إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين أرأيت الذي يكذب بالدين فذلك الذي يدع اليتيم ولا يحض على طعام المسكين فويل للمصلين الذين هم عن صلاتهم ساهون الذين هم يراءون ويمنعون الماعون الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله